Fopma off the fingertips right there, looking for that high line shot. And Jenny Kropp put the point on the board to start. Whitney Pavlik set to serve, working on Brooke Sweat, the shorter of the two from an offensive angle. Off the block, Jenny Kropp working well at the net already. There's two blocks, one play. Jenny Kropp puts that one down, good for the point, 2-0. As we take a look back, Kropp blocks once and twice for the point. Hard earned. So off the net, and Brooke Sweat, arms in place, but that one caught the bottom of the tape and kind of hung there for a second before dribbling out at an angle not foreseen by Brooke Sweat. Whitney Pavlik set to serve yet again, this time to Fopma. Fopma with an opportunity here. She cuts one in, dug by Pavlik, and goes to the same spot this time. The point goes 1-3. And I'm joined once again here in the booth by Matt Romanowski. And Matt, quite a bit of energy down there, would you say? What's the feeling on the sand?
It's energetic.
It's great.
Great job, Matt. No, it really is incredible down there. The crowd is just absolutely wild. You see the JJ running around with the Manhattan Beach flag, everybody going crazy. It is just a great environment. You take a look at the pier, just loaded with people. Unbelievable. If you're a beach volleyball fan, ladies and gentlemen, you've got to come to this tournament. As we take a look at Jenny Kropp, 4-1, off to a good start, working on Brooke Sweat, who swings around the back, nobody up. Nice, high shot, upped. Look at Whitney Pavlik stretching it. Back to Sweat. Here goes Sweat again around the back, scoring off the block. Kropp is there, both of them pick it up. Passed by Fopma, pushed out to Fopma. Another incredible rally here on Stadium Court. Chance to finish, ducked by Sweat.
Well, Fopma sends it up, there's...
And Jenny Kropp into the net.
That was quite a rally right there as we take a look back at what took place. Jenny Kropp into the net, of course that is a fault. And the resulting point, here's another look back. Yeah, just the forearms there along the tape. Looked like a good call, of course, Jenny Kropp disputing that, not officially, but definitely in disagreement.
Oh, nice little crafty shot on two.
And Kropp definitely known for quick shots on two. Very impulsive with that particular functionality here in the game. Something that happens pretty frequently and is difficult to foresee. Here's Whitney Pavlik back to serve. 3-point spread being maintained by Kropp and Pavlik, the reigning champs, not just so far in the series, but of this tournament last year. Nicely done. Brooke Sweat finds a spot wide open and exploits. Down the middle, Brooke Sweat with the ace.
Brooke Sweat. 4-5.
And there it is, Brooke Sweat. She sends one right down the middle and putting her opponent's communication skills to the test there. And that one flies out of bounds.
Served by Sweat. Sweat, dug by Pavlik. Pavlik with a chance to score to go to 7. And her cut shot falls just a bit short. And that, due to the block of Jennifer Fopma, is why these two teams are so even. Take a look at the replay. Fopma definitely changing the shot of Whitney Pavlik. Fopma, an outstanding blocker as well as Jenny Kropp. Two great blockers, two great defenders facing off again. A rematch of the Manhattan Beach. of the Hermosa Beach final. And you see again, Whitney Pavlik has not missed that shot all day long, Luke, just missing two in a row. Six all. And Brooke Sweat with the pickup, a chance to take the lead. Oh, she does, big rip cross court. As we take a look at the replay, Brooke Sweat with the dig, then just punishing the ball off the hands of Whitney Pavlik. Fopma going after Pavlik. Pavlik to tie it up at sevens. Nice looping shot that lands in for the point. Down the line, we'll switch sides.
Very casual highline roll shot right there from Whitney Pavlik. For her to be throwing that one down pretty frequently throughout the day. Of course, how often it will work will remain in question. It's always trying to juke one of the spectacular defenders in the female field, and that's Brooke Sweat.
Here is Whitney Pavlik going after Fopma, switching it up. Fopma off the quick set, and a great shot. Outstanding play, Fopma and Sweat using a very quick set from Sweat out to Fopma to try to keep the defense of Whitney Pavlik and the blocking of Jenny Kropp off guard. Taking a look at Brooke Sweat again, growing up in Florida, just recently moving out here this summer. Her husband, teacher at the Manhattan Beach Elementary School, and came out here to pursue Brooke's dream, and she's living it right here with a chance to get her name engraved on the Manhattan Beach Pier. Eight all. Again, Luke, I know we talked about this before. Fatma and Sweat getting to the finals, literally missing the championship by a half an inch off a serve that drifted just out from Fatma. Now they go to Milwaukee, and they don't actually play against Kropp and Pavlik in Milwaukee, but they do take the title in Milwaukee at the shootout, beating Kristen Back and Raquel Fajeda, who had beaten Pavlik and Kropp. Fatma and Sweat have been there, but they have not beaten Kropp and Pavlik yet this year. Here's Jen Fatma stepping back to serve. She's got an advantage, 9-8.
Fatma with a good serve right there on two. Jenny Kropp smacks one down yet again. Solid spike from her. As we mentioned, definitely quick to hit that ball if it's up near the net on two. Typically, Whitney Pavlik is getting served out there and coming up with some very out of California, Irvine, originally from Laguna Beach. Former Rookie of the Year, firing one in very nicely. You can see the replay right there. Very excited with that. Low energy points are always nice out there, especially when things are really hot and, well, the pressure's in many ways on. Will they be able to repeat out here? That's all to come, as well as the men's championship coming up right after women's finals, which we're currently viewing. And big things going on out there. Of course, the Jose Cuervo girls running around, just throwing various freebie prizes, some swag going out to the loudest fans out there. We've had some competitions throughout the day. Adrian Carambola flying some sky balls into the air. People running out from the opposite end line trying to catch those things. There was some comedy there. And the Paul Mitchell head toss into products, which looks a lot like sand bowling, but using a head. It's like some sort of thing you would see on a primitive island,
yes,
where someone had landed,
and
beheaded.
A Mayan tradition there.
Mayan tradition. Thank you. That's what I was looking for.
But, you know, there really are. There's some great promotions, good crowd participation. A lot of the fans can come in and win a lot of free prizes here. T-shirts from Jose Cuervo, and it really is fantastic. Another tough serve to Brooks Webb. Let's see if she can score. Dug by Pavlik. Pavlik to go to 19. Pushing it and shoveling it back over to Brooke Sweat. Needs to score here, and she does, off of the hands of Jenny Kropp.
And Brooke Sweat out of Florida, one of those very skilled athletes. When I first met her, running around with the likes of Kristen Batt, you know, Joe Rohr, always in the area holding it down. Just a gentleman out there. And the whole gaggle down from Florida, just making big things happen. And Brooke Sweat, her success of late has in many ways been due to a solid attitude and serious determination, as well as natural talent in the sport.
Absolutely an outstanding defensive player. And here she goes, going after Jenny Kropp. And Fatma's there with the block. Kropp's gonna go on two, and she does, and she scores down the middle.
Well, Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik currently leading by 3 points, and well, If you listen to the sound bite there, Jen Fopma really, really wanting to overturn this game. It's late in set number one right now. A lot of energy been expended by both teams.
So much history with both of these teams. Kropp and Pavlik have been notorious in finals to lose game number one. The last time they faced, what did they do? They won game number one and then lost game number two and sent it to a game number three that was an absolute battle. Sweat everywhere. Pavlik will push it over. Fopma, can she score? The set. And Jenny Kropp says no way.
Kropp right there with that right hand. Fantastic timing. And sends that ball right back down and in. You know, things got slowed down here. Kropp with, as I said, fantastic timing right there. Just a fabulous bit of play at the net. So here we have game point. Drop serves, Brooke Sweat finds it. Here's Sweat up. Rolly shot right there, good for the point. And they avoid it, and game point one. Jennifer Fopma, smacks one in, knuckleball swaying in the wind, and here comes Pavlik with a chance, and that'll do it. Game number one in the books. Whitney Pavlik and Jenny Kropp taking top honors there. Things far from over here, folks. Of course, game two and a potential of game here. Last year's champion and the reigning champions here from the 2012 Jose Cuervo Beach Volleyball Series summer. And, well, they put the first game on the board as their own. 21-17 was the final score there. And here we are ready to kick off game number two. Jen Fopma, Brooke Sweat set to serve. Brooke with the Spalding. Their sole ambition to dethrone Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik. Here's Kropp. She crushes one down the line. Good for the point. Thank you. Pavlik, good toss. Found by Brooke Sweat, solid pass. Low set, and that one flies out of bounds very quick. Trying to get the jump on the defense there. Sweat fires it through, but just a little long.
Brooke Sweat and Jennifer Fama cannot afford to fall down early. Here in set number two. Pavlik and Kropp just playing very consistent, so solid. There's a nice deep pokey shot by Brooke Sweat that lands in for the points. They get on the board 1-2. Looking at the wind, Luke again blowing offshore, directly offshore, really not affecting the players. The grandstand sort of blocking that wind. Going after Pavlik and Kropp. What a brilliant shot on two. She's been using that all tournament long, and it's virtually been unstoppable.
She's very quick, and with just sensational passes coming off the arms of Whitney Pavlik, it has become a pretty consistent opportunity for her to score points.
And that serve sails just a bit out. 2-3 on the scoreboard. Brooke Sweat, Florida Gulf Coast University. Two career wins. She steps back to serve. The jumper going deep and missing. Wide to the left.
out of bounds.
14,
chipping
19.
Away. Sweat. The old annoyer catching the tape, rolling over for the ace serve. Such a tough one. There's really not a lot that can be done in this circumstance. I mean, not only did it dribble over the net, but it landed on the line additionally. So that one's going to put points on the board, irregardless of your four sides. That's just one guy's opinion. That's me. Oh, hey, big ups, folks. Peter Bigler in the audience. So, you know, just the fans, the friends, and, you know, the fortunate out here in Manhattan Beach. Dancing women, of course, Jose Cuervo. That's just sort of the way it goes. We've got some huge fans up there waving everything in sight. The vibe here is incendiary, I would venture to say. And just an absolute madhouse, both inside and outside, as people are fighting over who gets to play courts. You know, it's almost like when you're a child and you go to your brother's football game, you want to have your own football game off to the side. Well, that's definitely going on around this area as well. So, you know, just good times being had by all, and we encourage that right here front and center. Well, of course, Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik taking a break right there. They saw that a big measure had been taken and some momentum was being gained by Brooke Sweat and Jen Fama. They wanted to put an end to that quickly, as they'd like to do with this championship match, and end things in 2-15-19. And here comes Brooke Sweat yet again. Really shot. Oh, grabbed by Sweat. This will be a big, big point if they can pull it off. And Sweat with another opportunity. She sends it back court, and the jumbo's good. You almost can't help but look to the underdog and want to inject into them some intensity, because the crowd's starting to feel it, and I believe that that may be what's taking place right around here, the energy exchange. 3 points behind now. Another point here would be massive. Line is open, and Pavlik fires angle. Gets it. Match point reached. As beckoned by Matt Romanowski, the entirety of the folks, the fans, spectators here, move to their feet, as is traditional. Shot fired in from Whitney Pavlik. Here comes Brooke Sweat. This is it. She gets a hold of it, and Jenny Kropp dusts it again. They take the Manhattan Beach Open Women's Championship for the second year in a row. And that classic backwards knuckle on two for Kropp. She and Whitney Pavlik have won another Jose Cuervo Pro Beach Volleyball Series stop here in 2012, leaving the world of pro beach volleyball females wondering, who is it going to be that brings them down? Well, at this moment, one thing's for sure, there will be zero bringing down, because until the next tournament, they still lie on vibes of the beach. He's down there holding it down, and a few more words certainly coming from him. Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik, a lot of photo ops.
And of course, as is customary, ladies and gentlemen, here in Manhattan Beach, I'd like to present Mayor Wayne Powell, Mayor of Manhattan Beach, to present the plaques to Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik.
Well, the mayor there.
Mayor Wayne Powell.
Giving the plaques to the gals, their second time receiving this glorious award. What a treasure for beach volleyball professionals. There they are, the two girls just hoisting that glory-filled honor
and
up in the
Jenny
air.
Jenny Kropp, what a great year you guys have had as a team. Talk about how important it is to you to be the back-to-back Manhattan Beach Open champion.
It feels really good to be able to come back and defend our title. I know we had a lot of nerves coming into this weekend, and I'm so happy that we produced and we stuck together and played well. It feels awesome. Thank you to the crowd for coming and supporting us. This is the best place to play ever in the world. This is awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much to our family and friends who came out from everywhere and the crowd. It's Manhattan Beach Open, and you guys made it amazing. It couldn't have been any better. Getting on the pier twice, wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're back-to-back Manhattan Beach Open champions. Whitney Pavlik and Jenny Kropp, congratulations, ladies.
Well, thank you as well, Matt Romanowski. Big congratulations to Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik down there making huge